Hi everybody and welcome to Naio Nails. In this video we are going to do my makeup. You've all asked for this video. You all keep saying how much you love my makeup and you'd love to see me do it. I don't know if you just want to see me with no makeup on. I'm not sure. But anyways, to hell with it, we're going to do it. So I'm going to show you how to create my filming makeup. And next time you see me, I'll have no makeup on. So this is me with no makeup on. So you can probably see I have my eyebrows tattooed on that need doing again because they are fading, so I need to get those topped up. But I'll show you exactly how I start this. So this is all about my filming makeup, and to be honest, this is it's a little bit like the makeup that I wear when I go out. I'll change things a little bit, but this is definitely just my filming makeup. I will put a little bit of serum on, so I've just got some Beauty Lab serum there. I'm mainly going to put this just around my eyes because I get quite a lot of dryness around my eyes. Right, so I'm going to start with my foundation, which I just use Revlon Colourstay. I've used Revlon Colourstay for years. I've tried lots of different other stuff, but I just really like this. I'm just going to pump some of that out. Start to put it on. And I'm going to blend that with my brush. Just going round and round in circles, making sure when I come down to my neck, I blend it down my neck. We don't want any of them horrible tan line things. What do they call them? Like a tide line?
Tide mark.
Tide mark, that's it. So you see some girls have this like orange, like a bright orange tide mark, because they've clearly chosen the wrong foundation for their skin colour. And you can see that I've got a lot of freckles because I am a natural redhead. Yes, I know. It's shocking, but you know. I like quite a good coverage because of my freckles. I hate my freckles. I've always hated them. If I'd got really pretty freckles, like just here and here, I'd be fine with that. But they're in all the wrong places. And then what I use is a contour and highlighter. It's a liquid one. So I'm going to go under my eyes because I hate this part of my eye here. Because you can see that has like some luggage going on here. So we go underneath and we brighten that area. So now I'm going to contour with obviously the darker colour. I run it down the side of my nose as well because I can't afford a nose job. I have it here, my jawline and underneath there. So using a sponge, I'm going to start to blend this. You just literally stippling and dabbing that to blend it. If you wipe with a sponge, you would just then start to take it off. I'm doing all the lighter sections first. I'm going to do my eyes. I am going to use this highlighter to cover any bits of freckles or spots. And just pat it. And it'll just blend it out. Then we're going to blend the darker bits. I will leave my nose to last. And what this is going to do is shade underneath my jawline, so make me look like our cheekbones. And when you if you shade at the top of your forehead here, it will shorten your forehead as well. I forgot one bit. That'll just shorten the nose a little bit. I've had to be so brave to do this video because one of my nightmares is people seeing me with no makeup on. So I used to get really scared when I had a new boyfriend and think, oh God, he's got to see me with no makeup on. And it used to be really quite hard for me to do. I always knew I must really like him if I let him see me with no makeup on. So I've got a loose powder. I just knock it into the lid. But what I have to do before I put that on is check under my eyes that they haven't started to crease. And if they have, I'll just go under with the sponge. Sometimes I might put a little bit more of the highlighter on, which I think I will do. Just a little bit. And just using the very tip of the sponge. And then to stop that from creasing straight away, I'll powder it straight away. I know that that's done. Again, I'm just gonna seal it all in with the translucent powder. I can't believe I'm letting you all see me with no makeup on. I must be crazy. Essie's love this, as you know. Essie's love for you guys. The viewers. Right, so now I'm gonna powder contour. So I'm gonna like bronze, do a cheek. So I've got a pinched brush that I'm gonna use to come down here. It's quite a cheap contouring powder. It's nothing expensive, it's just a sleek one. I've had it for a long time. And I'm gonna go under my chin. So I'm gonna go into the powder and knock some of it off. It's because if I went straight into the powder and I didn't knock any off and I went straight on, I'd have quite a big bulk of the product and then it'd leave some of it behind and I'd get an uneven. I get an uneven patch, so I always knock it off a little bit. I've got a big brush with my bronzer from H&M, so I'm going to knock it off and I'm going to do my neck, blending that contouring over the top of my head. With the brush that I used before, I'm not going to put anything else on it because I can use the residue of what is left on the brush to go down the side of my nose on the end. I literally get the bronzer brush and go up the sides. And then I will use this pad. Look at the mess I'm making. Such a messy girl. You clean that up later, Adam.
Probably.
Yeah. Right, so now I need a bit of colour in my face, don't I? So I've got this Illamasqua, which is my favourite. It's like a coral kind of colour. I've got quite a short dumpy brush. You need the tiniest amount of this, it's so pigmented. I'm just gonna go in again, knock it off. And literally do the apples of my cheeks. And then I'm going to use this OMG from Illamasqua, which is a highlighter. And I literally, can you see where I have put my finger? Mm. I literally go like this. And go up my nose. I clearly don't just leave it like that. And then I just blend that with my bronzer brush. And then I've got another brush that I use in the highlighter to go across the top of my cheeks. I will get a little bit of the OMG and put a tiny bit at the top of my lips there, which will just highlight that a little bit. And I'll do my eyebrows, which is like one of the main things about my face. So I'm going to start with, where is it? I've got an NYX pencil, which is fatter on one side than it is the other. I don't know if you can see that slightly. So it's, see how it's thicker there, and you turn it and it goes thinner. You're going to use the thicker side, and I start from the middle. Start to create the thickness, and then I'm going to start to bring that down quite softly though. And then I've got an NYX brow pencil that is tiny, and I'm going to go right around the edge to make that really sharp. Maybe we should do a video where Adam does my makeup. Looks like
you look like Coco the Clown.
Yeah, you've got to watch this tutorial, Adam, and then you've got to do it.
Okay.
So you can see that that's made that sharper. It's more defined. Now to get them the same, it's always a task. You know, so I'm resting my hand on my face to keep myself steady. And then you're going to use this pencil and do some tiny little strokes. Create the illusion of hairs that I don't have many of, never have. I've got a friend that does it, and she does it with gel, and it looks quite cool on it. I think she's just got, I don't know, different skin. So once I've done that, I then seal this in, because it's a wax, because obviously when you use pencils and crayons, makeup ones, not like, you know, ones that
Crayola.
Not Crayola, colouring in what your kids have. No, they are wax. So I've been doing my eyebrows for a long, long, long time. So when I was at high school, I used to wear makeup, and I was one of those girls that got told off for wearing makeup. So I used to do my eyebrows with a pencil out there, and then if I touched them, they'd go like that. And that's because I never sealed them. So now I'm gonna use a slanted brush, and I'm going to seal it. I've got this Avon palette that I basically just use those two. I don't really use anything else. It's quite a light colour, it's a light brown. This is the only thing I really use it for, to be honest. So I use that light brown and I seal this part here. And then I've got a gorgeous palette from Illamasqua, which I absolutely love. And I'm gonna use this and this one with a slanty brush again. So the darker one, I will use right at the end. And then I'm using that sort of medium brown in the middle. And then with my bronzer brush, I'm just gonna go over to take off any excess. And they are now sealed and will last me for all day while I'm filming, because I tell you what, it gets hot in here. And if you feel like your face is starting to melt away. I've got this, which I love, because it's the same colour as my hair. I just love it. All I do is put it in the centre here of my lid. Just so I have a little bit of pink. Because I just love a little bit of pink. I used to hate pink. And then I've got Stealth, which I absolutely love, which is from Illamasqua again, which is a ivory colour. It's not white, it's not a bit of white, your colour, a bit of white. We know this girl, and she wears lots of white eyeshadow, and she looks really crazy. So I've got a sponge applicator. This palette that I've got here has got exactly the same colour. I clearly use that a lot, because there's hardly anything left, so I had to buy another one. So my eyes, in my opinion, are far too close together. So we have to create an illusion that they are further apart. So by highlighting here, and then adding shadow here, which we will do, we'll make them look further apart. And I'm gonna run that underneath a little bit. So this is matte shimmery powders on my eyes to make me look old. And then we're gonna highlight under my brow. I feel better now I've got some makeup on. I don't want everybody judge me for having no makeup on and looking like a totally different person. I'm sure I could rob a bank and then they wouldn't recognise me as soon as I put my makeup on.
Except for the pink hair.
Yeah, I might struggle with that. She came with a gun and she had pink hair! I am a bit of a perfectionist, so I do like things just so. That's why you'll see me just titivating a little bit. Put a tiny bit of that sort of ivory colour just there. And, oh, I know what I haven't done. If you get a tiny bit of that contouring colour, the darker one, and run it underneath there like that, just like that, it makes my bottom lip look bigger than it is. So I'm gonna put some eyeshadow on now, which will make my eyes look more dramatic. I'm gonna use the Illamasqua palette that I love. And I've got this brush, and I've had this brush for ages, and I love it. I could do the new one, but I haven't got the chance to get a new one. And I don't even think I can remember where I had it from. So I'm gonna use this. It's an angled brush, so it's gonna angle in like this. I start off with a lighter color and then build it up. Just like you would if when you're doing like art. So this is the canvas today, not nails. This is my canvas. So we use that sort of medium kind of brown. And I'm gonna pull my eye out because, you know, I want it tight. It's not as tight as I would like it. So you can see that I'm coming, you know, about a quarter of a way across my lid. I'm bringing it into the socket of my eye. So we've basically gone from light to darker. And we could do the old thing where you put some there and you go, oh, and you get a nice straight line. Oh, we don't need to do that. I had a phase of doing that. I had like a credit card or a bank card or something, a business card, put it there, and I thought, oh, I need to have a nice straight line. But then it just got too much. I couldn't be bothered to do it. I always do everything at the same time, so I wouldn't completely finish this eye and then go on to the other eye. I'm doing the same. So today is Monday, and later on I have to coach my football team, and I go straight after filming. So I go with like my filming makeup on in my football gear. And everyone thinks, you've only come in training or something. Right, so I've got a bit of powder on the pad and I'm just literally running it under there a little bit. Just to keep that nice and sharp. And then I'm gonna add some of this darker brown and a little bit of black. So we're building up the colour now. And obviously these are naturals, you know, I'm not using like a bright colour or anything like that. If I was going out, I'd probably add a little bit of colour in there, you know, of a night out. I would add a little bit, but for filming, I keep everything quite natural. The colours anyway, apart from a little bit of pink, of course. I've got a smaller brush. Clearly had this brush for a lifetime as well. It's a very good brushing. And then I'm gonna darken this corner. So you can sort of see the difference. So that's just made that look a little bit deeper set. And I know I'm doing this a day, and I don't know how long it's actually taking me, but it normally takes me about 15 minutes to do this makeup. So you can see I've created like a blend, so it goes from light to dark, and it also does the same here as well, so it goes from light to dark here. Applicator that I used before, and just go up the sides just to sharpen that. I make sure I've got my big brush to get rid of any loose powder that has fell anywhere. And I've also got this little tiny brush that I can make sure with more precision that everything's neat and I've got nothing on the under, well, the lower lid. I don't really wear anything on my lower lid unless I'm going out. Sometimes I wear, you know, I'll go round it, I'll smudge something round if I'm going out. Of a night out. Because I go out all the time, honest. I'm always out, I'm always nightclubbing and everything. Such a rebel. I wish. Super fat. Fat eye. Just realised what it's called, super fat eye. It's like a big fat marker and it's so easy to use. I got some other ones. I used this one. So it's like, oh, it's waterproof. Oh my God. And then you see how it's like, it's tiny and it's really flexible and it's a nightmare to use. And when you put it on, when you take it off, it's like peeling off PVA. You can literally paint it on, and when you take it off, you wash your eyes and it just rolls off like PVA. So I thought, no, I don't like that one. I'm literally gonna make sure my hand's clean first because I'm gonna touch my face. I do that sometimes. I go, oh, put black on my face or something like that. So I'm gonna use a big fat eye marker thing. This isn't a Sharpie, this is proper makeup, you know. Don't use Sharpies. I'm gonna pull my eye out so it's nice and tight, and then you just lay it down. And then what I don't want to do is close my eye completely. I don't want to open it completely because it might still be a little bit wet. Some black. So I use some black on a pointy applicator and go across and seal it. I've had people say to me, how do you keep it so black? How do you keep the flick so black? And it's just that bit of powder that seals it, that makes it so black. I'm going to make sure none of that's fell onto my cheek. And we're going to do exactly the same. I was starting to look more like me. Yes! See that Kirsty Meakin that you saw in the beginning of this video with no makeup on? That's not the real me. This is the real me. So same again. This is the hard bit. I'm sure everybody agrees. Little tip, if when you've got these like little marker things, if they start to run dry, put it back in the lid. Shake it down, make sure you put it in the lid, because if you don't, it'll go all over you. Shake it down like that, and it makes the tip wet again. So sometimes I'll turn up with my makeup on, sometimes I turn up without it on, don't I, Adam?
Mm-hmm.
It depends.
Then I know if I can do some editing.
Yeah. So I will just literally go in the bathroom, do my makeup, and it takes me about 15 minutes. it does! You cheeky sod. So I'm just sealing that again, like I did with the other eye. I don't just use one mascara, I use two mascaras. Because that would just be normal to use one, surely. I'll tell you the reasons that I use two mascaras. So we'll look at this one. This is just a Revlon Ultimate All-in-One. See how short it is. That means I can get right to the root. Because I'm an actual redhead, I have really pale eyelashes. I do have them tinted from time to time, but they still are really pale and you will see them. I'm not blessed with having dark eyelashes. And then I've got this other one, which is only a cheap one. What's it? I think it's a collection 2000 or something like that. It's cheap, but the brush is fantastic on it. So first of all, I use this little short dumpy one and I literally just go right to the root and give it a little bit of a wiggle. Same here. See, I went like that, then I'm using the other side of the brush now, so I don't actually have to put it back in. But I don't have to reload it. I don't do my bottom lashes with this though. And then I use a big fat one. Then I'll go into the root and brush all the way to the end. I'll do my rotten lashes. And I pull the funny face. Why do we pull them stupid faces when we do mascara? Everybody does it. Why can't I just do it like that? I have to go. Same again on this one. I have reloaded the applicator for this one. If you get any kind of lumps, I've got this amazing brush. I have no idea where it's from, but it's amazing. And it's got like little needles on the end. And watch, it's amazing. It just brushes through far better than a plastic one. And it just takes off the lumps, can you see? It's amazing. I can't live without it. Time for the lips. It's a lip time. I have got a, this is new to me, and the only reason I bought it is because it stays on and you can snog all night and it doesn't come off. It's fantastic. It's a Smashbox one, and honest to God, I thought it was overrated. It's amazing. I absolutely love it. So if you turn it like that, do you know what it does? It makes it pointy again. There's like a little tiny thingy in there. Sharpener, that's the word. A little sharpener in there, it makes it all pointy. So that's the lip liner done. Now, I'm gonna use, it's an NYX soft matte lip cream. So it's one of them that you put on, it's like a liquid lip thing. So you put it on and then it goes matte and it doesn't really budge all day, to be honest, it's brilliant. So it's brilliant for filming. I've got a NYX Wonder Pencil, whatever that is. It's basically like an ivory colour pencil, you can see. And I always put it on my hand first because it warms the wax and it applies a little bit better. And then I'm gonna go on my waterline. So it's not so red, I don't look so tired. I think we're done. Welcome to the new Kirsty Meakin. Okay, I hope you enjoyed that, guys. I hope it helped you in some way. Maybe you just wanted to see me with no makeup on. And if that's you, you're not, people. But anyway, I hope you enjoyed it. So what we're doing, we're actually creating a new channel just for makeup. Because those that didn't know, I'm actually a fully qualified theatrical makeup artist. So we're gonna do lots of makeup videos, so you can head over to that channel, click the link, and it'll take you straight to there and you can watch some makeup fun. All the products, all them beautiful products that we've used today are in the description box below. So don't forget to have a look, and I will see you all next time. Bye bye. And I'll definitely have makeup on as well.